Sometimes I block his head. Sometimes I go to the choke to push his elbow in. I set up in different ways. That's different ways to control the personal bottle too. You can also think about control both wrists. My heels are tight to the hip. I control both wrists here, right? I do that many times when I feel the person start to rotate the body too much. Think about bring the elbows inside my leg to hip skip, using the half guard defense, right? So many times when I feel he's rotating, I like to drive the wrist down, right? Just too slow so I'm not gonna fall. So they start to rotate. When I bring that wrist down, look what I do with my legs. I rotate my body and I kind of bring these toes to the ground. My knee will be behind the back and I pinch my heel and my knee against the stop part here. Does that make sense? I kind of in this position here. Of course, if I be too much high like that, that's a room. So what we usually do when he starts to rotate, I drive down, look. I start to bring my heel more close to his armpit, when I can drive his knee down, right? So I kind of stay on hand like that. I create a wall here with my leg. My toes maintain my position. If I'm like that, I don't have strength enough to maintain. So that's my body position maintain that. My heels are tight, my legs are tight, and I can start to control him from here. I have opportunity here to control his arm and just step over to armbar. Or I can keep him coming behind the head and lock his wrist here. My own arm, pull that and have a good control. If you talk about self-defense, this could be a good option. Right, you can control the aggressor, you can strike, right? If you talk about jiu-jitsu, you can just also keep him pulling and allow him to face the belly down, and this leg will naturally slide down to hook the leg. You see, so I start to pull him, putting pressure, I start to bring the heel down, look, when he starts to face, this is already a hook. When he's belly down, I keep him controlling the arm, and I will bring the other heel inside, so that is a hook. I open my knees, I spread my hip against his low back. There's not much he can do from here. So I can pull the front head to choke, or I can just maintain my position. I can sit bell when one arm come underneath the armpit, the other one come controlling the top of the shoulder. I can collar choke, or I can just pull him to me and start to work different attacks. The collar choke will work really well from here, right? So that's a little bit of mobility and transition, very basic one to the back, right? Fundamental class is always important to do the base and start to, even for the upper belt, start to remember some things. So I feel if I keep my knees tight to his body, when he starts to roll, if I don't step, he will roll over my leg. I will probably come down. That makes sense? So that's why it's necessary sometimes to step. We call this classic mount. When I step one leg, the other knee show the ground. So I feel he's rolling on my leg. I rotate, I step, I bring my heel close to his armpit, and I bring my knees down. He's not gonna roll, so allow him to roll, rotate. I allow him to roll. Or I'm gonna roll on your leg and take you down. Especially someone like him, heavy. If you allow him to start to come on your leg, he's gonna probably take you down. So from here, start to roll. Look, I allow him to roll. Start looking for control, bring my heels. I have a back there. Let's just work on that transition a little bit. One, two, three.